بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الحمد لله. As many of you know that our brother Ali Bennett, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his soul today. I think it was just before the Maghrib prayer. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make him of those who enter Jannah and to give him all the rewards. He's worked so hard, subhanAllah, as all of you know. And there's so many of you that actually understand the work that he has actually done. I'm not sure if many of you know, but I've never actually taken a photo with him for the sake of not abusing his position to further our organization. I've always refused doing that. We sat many times. I've actually done hijama on Brother Ali over the years many times, subhanAllah. And I actually seen his condition deteriorate over the years. One thing I just want to mention is that, you know, many of us are affected by his passing away. But one thing that Ali done that many people didn't do is that he worked hard. When he found that he had cancer, you know, they gave him 6 months or whatnot, and subhanAllah, he didn't just sit down, he didn't go, you know, sit in the corner and do nothing. He got up and did something. And this is my message to you, and I'm sure this is what he wants all of you to do, is to get up and to do something. Don't just sit back. We say, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on his soul 100%. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he enlightens his grave, that he gets all the rewards, but do something. You know, I'm actually going to find out, inshallah. I've contacted one of the brothers that work very closely to him to see if he's finished all his projects. If he hasn't finished the projects in terms of funding, you know, I'm going to take that on personally and try to push so that we can finish the projects that he started. Again, what we need to do is not just to sit down and cry. We need to get up and do something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember, doing something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in memory of him, yes, so that we try to finish the charities that he did, the orphanages, the schools and whatnot that he tried to do, but also trying to get reward for yourself. Remember, Ali was greedy in that sense. He did so much, so the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his soul, like now, how Allah took his soul, he could actually gain these rewards. So when he enters the grave, he's going to see these rewards, and inshallah, on the day of judgment, when he faces Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's going to see all these rewards in front of him. Again, let's do something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's see what we can do so that we can finish off the projects that he started, inshallah. If you've already been donating to his cause, continue to donate so that we can try to finish all the projects that he's done. If you haven't, inshallah, just wait, inshallah. I'm meeting with a brother in the next couple of days that's part of his organization, inshallah, and let's see how we can finish off everything. Again, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless, to make it easy on him. Remember, he just passed away. His soul would have been taken up. And inshallah, I'm not too sure when the actual dafni is, or when the funeral is. That's when he goes back after the people have buried him. His soul goes back into his body. He's going to get questioned in the grave. And then we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on him. Jazakumullah khair. And salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Meet Ali Bennett, a friend of mine. A young Muslim born and raised in Sydney, Australia, who has lived quite a successful life. However, it was only recently that his life took a dramatic turn. This is Ali's story. Where are you at now with your life? What's happened to you?
At this point in my life, wallah, yani, I've been gifted, yani, alhamdulillah, by Allah, with yani, cancer throughout my body. And yani, I've changed my whole life to sort of helping people.
Why do you call it a gift, Ali?
And alhamdulillah, it's a gift because and it's a gift because yani Allah's given me a chance to change.
What has having cancer, what has it opened your eyes to?
Yani, subhanAllah, everything in life, yani, even the yani, smallest gift, like yani, breathing fresh air.
Do you feel like you used to take that for granted before? How long have you had cancer?
4 months now.
Ali was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer and given only 7 months to live. Upon finding the news, he immediately sold his successful business and was forced to reconsider the lavish lifestyle he was accustomed to. Everything was to change.
Ali, what was your reaction when you came to know you had cancer?
I got rid of my cars, got rid of my watches, even my clothes. I took them with me overseas and I gave them to a lot of people up there. So I wanted to try to leave this world without anything.
So you were on a mission to get rid of your dunya.
It wasn't until Ali invited us into his room that we truly understood the luxurious lifestyle that he was living and the extent of the sacrifice that he was making.
What's all this, Ali? Talk to me, explain this.
It's a bracelet, yani. It costs about $60,000. Yeah.
What do you have in these boxes, Ali?
They're all my shoes, alhamdulillah.
Louis Vuitton?
All Louis Vuitton.
How much is something like this worth, Ali?
They're probably about 1300.
How much you pay for that, Ali?
About 700.
Thongs?
For a pair of thongs, yeah.
So what's happening with the sunglasses here, Ali?
I just like collecting different sunglasses.
Yeah?
I've got rid of a lot of them. I gave them to a couple of brothers in Africa, alhamdulillah.
So you're telling me there's a kid in Africa that's walking around with Louis Vuittons and... Can I try one of these hats on? I've only mentioned them in my talks like 100 times.
You can try the red one on. It's limited edition one. Barakallah.
What do you reckon, Els?
Sheikh Gucci.
Ali's interest in the dunya has left him abruptly and no longer holds a place in his heart.
So Ali, what do you feel now, like when you look at this?
And driving something like this doesn't really cross my mind anymore. It's not, and it's not something I would want to do no more. After someone tells you, or you find out that you're sick, or you haven't got much time in this life, wallah, this is the last thing, yani, you would want to chase. And this is how we should be living our life every day.
Car like this, people would love to be in it. People would love to own. People would love to drive it.
Wallah, they're going for the wrong goals. And you realise that when you get sick, when someone tells you you haven't got long to live, you realise all this stuff, it does not benefit us in any way.
So what's the value of this in your heart now?
This is worth, yani, one pair of thongs for a little African child with no thongs. Wallahi, it's worth more than me to see him smile with a pair of thongs than own one of these. Wallahi al-Azim.
Ali has since dedicated the remainder of his life and wealth to helping those who are far less fortunate than him. After an emotional journey to Africa, Ali has established a charity titled Muslims Around the World Project. The organization wasted no time in the construction of a masjid and a school in Africa to serve as an ongoing charity for him when he finally has to depart this world.
Well, it all started from when I went to the cemetery when a brother that has the same, that has cancer passed away. And I was at the cemetery and I was just thinking to myself, you know, after you go, there's nothing. There's no one there for you. No mother, no father, no brother, no sister, except for your deeds. Even your money is not going to be there for you. So the only thing that's going to be there for you is a sadaqah. And that's the only thing that's going to help you gradually for your time in the grave till you get to the ultimate destination.
وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور.